Welcome to part 6 of building the race course. Today we're going to learn how to build a board, which is going to come down this way. We don't have to build all of the board map, just enough for to see from the race course. We're going to build a board all the way down here, a little car park here, and then we'll put some fences on the course, and then we do call the waypoints for the way the horses run, and then after that we do some sections of finishing touches for you, like this bit behind the stands and other things in different parts. But we're going to build the road first, and we're going to make a little gap here in these trees. They're going to have to be moved, so I move a tree here to click entities, not move them, just move them to a different part. Put your pointer on the tree, press control, and you just move the trees in one at a time. Just a couple of minutes. It's just to build a road way in. We're going to flood fill it in. You can spray it in, but flood fill here makes it have clean edges, and we can use a gravel for this old way. So you just want, so you can see from, you're not going to see it all the way up here from when the horses are racing, so you don't need to worry about going all over the map. So you click terrain, tip grid off, and flood fill, and as usual and keep it to a clean edge. This can be a gravel road, gravel track. So, you know, it's not going to be black tar. I don't like black tar because I can't just game right. I'm going to build a little car park here. Try and keep it thin a bit, of course, it's wider if you want to, or the field. Now I'm going to choose a different gravel. Click back up into the beginning. I'm going to have to go into Lucas E Drive. I'm using the Steam version of the game. This is being Steam Amps. Don't get a terrain. Well, we're going to use a gravel. As you see, you've got different sorts of gravel. I like this one. That one can be too colory. That one. I'll take this one. I like this sort of one over, and then filling with polygons. So it's pretty versatile. Again, you put your end of your howl on the in this little black arrow down in the box. I click left, hold it down, and I scroll with the mouse. bus wheel in the middle. Let's check this. As you see, that's given me a nice little car park. Right, and a finish zone. I'll click finish. In and then press save so we don't lose what we've already got in case the editor crashes, and this crashes quite often, so you know, save regularly, otherwise you have to go back and redo it. It's very glitchy. Done this, we can go and put some fences on the track. There we go, that looks okay. That's your road in, gravel track. Don't worry about these little bits here, I will do them later on. I'll just, when I finish the course up, now we're gonna put some fences on there. I'm gonna have a ditch down there. Done this far side, so what I like to do is I like to press Y to see the map underneath, so I know where to plant. But basically, as you can see the outlines. There's three down this side. One, two, three. First you do is click into fences. You click entities first. And then you click fences, and these are your fences, the entry fences down there. I don't really bother with these, only use the top one or the second one. You can use the second one, these are plain fences. So if I click one there, now straighten this up, and I use the numpad 5 and 4. 4 goes up, 5 to come down, 6, 5 to straighten it. Now, you can either make this fence bigger, or wider, or longer. I'm going to use letters for this. I wanted this, your widers. I like to the fence, click on it, just click back of it. Click on the fence, press U, that makes it thicker, J makes it thinner, I breaks it higher, K takes it back down, O stretches it, L shrinks it. So that's how you resize your fences. So I'm going to delete that one, start new. See how this, that's okay. Then I'll just stretch out a little bit. Just the hole. Make sure it's okay. Looks okay. Jump on the brow. Do one by here. Wider part of the course. Now I'm going to put these on the rail, inside rail, because then we have a proper line for the ones that are out. Sometimes I'll use the fences in the middle, but then that means the waypoint should be in the middle. Another one by here. We'll put a ditch in. One in the arm straight. horses. A little running. Turn around. I'll be too short of running, I believe. I'll do. We'll have a little run in. Then this side of the track. It's just the one, I think. And that's down there. We'll put one down there. Seems to be a small course, oak lodge. Straight. And then there are two down this side. There's one going there, as you can see, and one there. And what we do, we'll have another plain one here. And we won't kick it right in because we'll keep this in the centre. The next fence we're going to put in is going to be a ditch. So, and we use number 5, the ditch. I liked it. Take it. As you can see, that's pretty wide. So what I'll do, I'll press J to pin the map. Pull to be just K then to move on. I'll press 5 to turn it around. In the ditch. There you go. Oh, good look. That looks okay. So, that's all the fences. What you need now is the guiding rails. And you clip on track. That's at the top. On the third one down, you have fence 1 and 4, that's what we use. So, I'll click that. You turn this around the same way as you do the others, so make sure you, when you move it, the howl and hold down control up. Bit pickety. That side down. The fence needs straightened up. And time to go forward here, yeah, and move the mouse at the same time, so but on the other fence, because I got them on the wheels, I'm only going to put side fence on the outside because the wheel will guide him in. So we'll just pull on the other side. I'll be in the middle, of course, then. You know, wheels. You put them on both sides. Using the D now, straighten up a bit. Have to. And straighten it up again. Thank you. few minutes at the moment, so perhaps I should do the waypoints in part 7. I think that fence is too big. I'm going to shrink it so stop the fence. Just shrink it just a little bit. So easy to pull away then. One down this side now. And that's completely done. And that's your fence is built. So what I'll do, I won't have time to do the waypoints now because that's going to be very important for some people to learn. So what I'll do is so. Right now, but I'll do a quick flood fill on this back of the course to fill in. So, right, but I'm going to separate this. Let's see, not checking that big, I know once the game starts. Dry glass for this. I'll finish that. Now this bit. I'll do a little mark there. I'll do that blur. Final bit, which is with the people going to be standing on the ground. A dry number 2 dry JPEG. I'll use spleens this time. Keep it at the straight edge. There we go. And tidy it up. Finish. I That set has 20 minutes. That's part 6. I'm sorry I didn't get to do the waypoints. That'll be first thing we do in part 7. Doing the car park. The fences took longer now. Hoping it would take. But you get the gist of it. That's nearly enough. The race course finished on the other side. We just got to do the waypoints for the way the course the horses are away from. And a couple of touches and then the race course will be finished. So two more lessons after this should be done and dusted. So I'll see you in part 7 for the waypoints.